Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another season of Hopkinton Hillers Softball. Here from Hopkinton High School, Tom Nappy and Mike Tarosian on the call for this afternoon's game. It is the home opener for the Hopkinton Hillers, who are 3-0 on the season, and today they take on the 4-1 Milford Scarlet Hawks as we are ready for softball. Stepping in is the righty, Kate Irwin, and she will take a strike there. And that will make the count 0-1 on the mound for the Hillers. It is Heather Hawley as there's a bunt up the middle. Hawley fields, throw to first, one away. And a nice start to the afternoon for the Hillers. A 1-3 ground out for Kate Irwin. That will bring up Emily Pierre-Gustavo, the shortstop for the Scarlet Hawks, who are led by head coach Steve DeVito. The Hopkinton Hillers led by first-year head coach Scott Soderberg, who took over the reins from Kylie Murray, who was the head coach last season. Of course, Scott Soderberg has a lot of experience with this Hillers softball team, as he was the assistant coach for a few years as well. That pitch is just inside to Pierre-Gustavo, and that'll make the count 1-1. As Pierre-Gustavo steps back in the box, the pitch from Hawley is just low. We'll take a look at the Hillers field. It's Lily Morningstar in center field, Katie Hawley in right field, Lindsay Whittles in left field, Molly Bennett the shortstop, Madison Abbott over at first base, Emma Murphy at third base, Emily Whalen is the second baseman. Is that pitch just outside? That got away briefly. That will make the count 3-1 on Pierre-Gustavo. The Milford batting order, Kate Irwin led off with a ground out. Emily Pierre-Gustavo up now. Jess Tomaso, the left fielder, batting third. Caitlin DiCapua, the third baseman in the cleanup role, as that one's low, and Pierre-Gustavo draws the walk. Kelly Reichert, the first baseman. Emily Hartman, the catcher, is batting sixth. Maddie Bonvino, the second baseman, batting seventh. Allie Atherton, the pitcher, batting eighth. And Shannon Cormier, the right fielder, will round out the Milford Scarlet Hawks batting order as Jess Tomaso steps in. And this is on the ground, first base side. That's going to get through for a base hit. Pierre-Gustavo around second. The throw to third is going to be in time, but it got away from the third baseman, and everybody's safe. That is going to be a single with an advance on the throw in by Tomaso. And Pierre-Gustavo ends up at third. It's two runners in scoring position for Milford with the cleanup hitter, Caitlin DiCapua, coming up to the plate. It was a good throw in from right field from Hawley, but just got away from the third baseman, Emma Murphy. So one out, two on for the cleanup hitter, Caitlin DiCapua. She certainly has some power behind her swing, and there's a strike. Heather Hawley has had a nice start to the season. Hillers 3-0, they got a win against a very good Norton team. As this one's popped up third base side, Murphy is under it, and she will be called off by the shortstop, who will make the catch. Good job there by Molly Bennett on the flyout. Wind will be a bit of a factor today, as that ball was blown around up in the air a little bit, and you can hear the wind right now, actually, as Kelly Reichert will step in, the first baseman. Lineup and the pitch, and that is in there for a strike. 0-1. Two outs, two on. Runners on second and third for Milford. Top of the first, just underway here at Hopkinton High School. As this one's on the ground, up the middle, off the pitcher. Hawley will pick it up, and the underhand throw to first in time. A nice recovery there to get the third out. Hit, two men on, but no harm done. We head to the bottom of the first. It's a scoreless game between Milford and Hopkinton. Bottom of the first inning, the Hopkinton Hillers coming up for the first time this season on their home field. And technically they already played a home game against Dover Sherbourne, but that game was actually at Medway High School due to a lot of rain wrecking the field conditions. But either way, they are 3-0 on the season, looking for their fourth win of the year against a very good Milford Scarlet Hawks team, as Lily Morningstar will lead things off for the Hillers. Let's take a look at their batting order. It's Lily Morningstar, the center fielder, leading things off. Katie Holly, the right fielder, batting second. Lindsay Whittles, the left fielder, batting third. Molly Bennett, the shortstop, batting cleanup. Heather Hawley, the pitcher, batting fifth. Emma Murphy, the third baseman, batting sixth. Madison Abbott, the first baseman, batting seventh. Julia DiBenedetto, the designated player, batting eighth. And Emily Whalen, batting ninth. She is the second baseman. As Morningstar set to step in, we'll take a look at the Milford field as well. It's Allie Atherton on the mound for the Scarlet Hawks, and she has been a sensational pitcher over the last couple of seasons for Milford. As there is a bunt to lead things off, it is fouled away. Let's take a look at the infield for the Scarlet Hawks. Kelly Reichert over at first base. At second base, it's Maddie Bonvino. Shortstop is Emily Pierre-Gustavo. Caitlin DiCapua is at third. We'll go right to left now as Shannon Cormier in right field. Kate Irwin in center field. Jess Tommaso, the left fielder, as Morningstar awaits the pitch. The bunt is down, slow roller, throw to first in time. A good play by the third baseman coming all the way in to get to that one, and we will start things off with a ground out. That'll bring up Katie Holly to the plate. Katie Holly, the right fielder for the Hillers, off to a pretty good start this season. 262 batting average last year. And she takes a strike there, 0-1. Atherton is set to deal. As that one is fouled away, third base side. Well, slow start at the plate this year for Holly, the sophomore, 143. She has scored three runs and driven in a run. An 0-2 count. Atherton set to deal. Line up and the pitch. Swinging strike, two away. Well, this is going to be a great pitching battle here this afternoon between Allie Atherton and the Hillers' Heather Hawley. Two very good pitchers out there, as Lindsay Whittles will come to the plate. Whittles a 286 so far on the season. She's had seven official at-bats, scored four runs and driven in one. Atherton set to deal, and that one's up high, 1-0. Atherton waits the sign. Deals, grabs the outside corner, a nice pitch there. Whittles last year hit a 298 overall. Atherton delivers, that's fouled away, 1-2. She also had a 389 on base percentage. And was pretty clutch as well at times for the Hillers, who had a great run last season. Atherton awaits the sign and delivers. There's a swinging strike, two strikeouts in the inning for Atherton, and the Hillers go down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the first. To the top of the second we go. We are scoreless between Milford and Hopkinton. Top half of the second inning, the Scarlet Hawks coming back up to the plate. A scoreless game between Hopkinton and Milford, as Emily Hartman, the catcher, steps in, and she'll take ball one up high, 1-0. Hey, pitch there is in there for a strike by Holly. Little sinker on that one. One, two. That one's fouled away. One and two the count. Catcher for the Hillers is a freshman, Julian Cedia. She's the odd man out of the batting order today, but supposed to be a great catcher. As this one's hit deep to left and foul. And that was just shy of home run territory. Blew a little bit to the left there. And more than likely, if that stayed fair, it would have cleared the fence. Count remains one and two. It's Emily Hartman, Maddie Bonvino, and Allie Atherton. The catcher, second baseman, and pitcher due up for the Scarlet Hawks. Holly delivers, and this one's hit to the left side, foul. Feeling the pull is Emily Hartman. But just pulled that one a little bit too far to the left side. Wind up and the pitch. That one just low. There's a swinging strike. Well, wait a minute, did she foul Tippy? Yes, she did, says the umpire. Foul 2-2 remains the count. Staying alive is Emily Hartman. A good battle here between Hartman and Holly. We'll get you the stats on Holly in just a moment. She has done sensational from the mound so far this season. She has started two games, completed the two games. Has a zero ERA. There's a pitch and a strike for the first out. That was a good breaking pitch there from Holly, and now Maddie Bonvino will come up to the plate.
Come on, Maddie, start it off, kid, let's go.
And strike one there. Heather Holly has pitched 12 innings so far this season. Take you through the Hillers schedule so far this year as well. That one just high. Wind up and the pitch, and this is hit in the air, fair territory, and it's going to drop in front of the third baseman. A miscommunication there. Emma Murphy appeared to call the pitcher Heather Holly off of it, and it ends up dropping, and that is going to be a foul anyway, so no harm done. Bonvino will step back in. She got lucky that that ended up out of play down the third baseline. It remains one and two. And I don't think she intentionally meant to let that drop, but it worked out for the Hillers. So far, Hopkinton has started off the season with a whole lot of offense as that one's fouled away into the backstop. And their first game of the season against Dover Sherbourne, which was technically a home game, was at Midway High School. They got the 25-1 victory. It was on Saturday, April 8th, and on April 11th at Medfield, a 13-0 win. As this one's popped up third base side, and it's off the glove of Murphy, and that one will get in. And Bonvino will reach on the error. So she came to a dive there. The wind took that a little bit, and that's what I mentioned earlier, that the wind will have a factor in this game. As Allie Atherton will step in, the pitcher. Getting back to the Hillers schedule, on April 13th at Norton, they got a 1-0 win and a great pitcher's duel against Kelly Nelson, who was expected to be the leading pitcher in the TVL, had a great year last year and was the league leader. But Heather Holly got the best of her in that one. That one is in there for a strike. One on, one out for the Scarlet Hawks. A 1-1 count to the pitcher, Allie Atherton. Fouled away, 1-2. Holly had a few relief appearances for Hiller's starter last season, Bree Mirabli, who had a great year. That one's outside. And she looked good in those relief appearances, but of course was never really in a starting role, so weren't quite sure what to expect, but so far it has been very good for Heather Holly, as that one is down low into the dirt. Runner's gonna take off from first, the throw's gonna be late, and Bonvino will advance on the wild pitch. Good speed there by the second baseman. Atherton steps back in. On the ground, up the middle, gloved by Holly. Throw to first is low, but it is recovered. They get the out at first, but Bonvino advances. So Atherton out on the 1-3 for the second out. Bonvino advancing to third, but there is two outs. So Shannon Cormier, the right fielder, will come up for Milford. Looks like that ball might have got stuck in Holly's hands a little bit as she tried to get it over to Abbott at first base, but fortunately for the Hillers, they were able to get that out. As this is a liner up the middle, that's going to score a run as it rolls into center field. Cormier will stop at first, and it's an RBI single. 1-0 Milford. Maddie Bonvino comes around to score. I'll bring up Kate Irwin. Stoppage by the umpire. Holly deals the bunt. Slow roller up the middle, picked up, throw to first. There's the third out, but not before the Scarlet Hawks plate a run. It is 1-0 Milford as we head to the bottom of the second. Bottom of the second inning, Milford leading Hopkinton 1-0 as they plate a run in the top half of the inning. Due up for the Hillers is the 4, 5, and 6 hitters. The shortstop, Molly Bennett, the pitcher, Heather Holly, and the third baseman, Emma Murphy. And they will face Allie Atherton, who had a nice first inning. Hillers went down 1-2-3 in the inning. As Molly Bennett steps in, the cleanup hitter for the Hillers. That one is just high, 1-0. Bennett awaits the pitch. There's a strike. 1-1. Molly Bennett so far this season, a .333 batting average, 11 plate appearances, 9 at-bats, has scored 7 runs, driven in 4. Atherton awaits the sign and deals. There's a swinging strike, 1-2. Atherton awaits the sign. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. As Bennett continues to battle. Last year, Molly Bennett hit a .308 overall. Played in 15 of the 20 games. Had a great season at the plate and has certainly earned the role as the cleanup hitter this year. As there's a swinging strike, she'll go down here, however, one away. That'll bring up Heather Holly. really trying to help her own cause here. And that run given up in the top of the second was an unearned run. So far, Heather Holly's ERA is still perfect, as there's a strike. As the run scorer, Maddie Bonvino, reached on an error. Wynn took the ball a little bit too far to the right for Emma Murphy to make the routine catch. On the ground, first base side, slow roller through the first baseman's glove, but she's able to pick it up, turn around, step on the bag for the out. An unassisted ground out there for Holly, two away, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Emma Murphy. Murphy steps in. 600 batting average so far for Murphy. She'll take a strike there. 3 for 5 at the plate. Has driven in 3 runs, scored 3 runs. As the junior awaits the pitch. Inside. 1-1. Atherton awaits the sign and deals. There is a strike, 1-2. 3 strikeouts so far for Allie Atherton for the Scarlet Hawks. Trying for her 4th right here. And this is up the middle. That's going to get through into left field, bobbled by the left fielder. And Murphy is aboard with the single. Jess Tomaso over in left field, but Murphy holds up at first. Madison Abbott, the first baseman, coming up to the plate. One on, 2 outs for the Hillers. Madison Abbott, a 250 so far at the plate, 2 for 8. Fouls that one away off the catcher, 0-1. Atherton awaits the sign and deals. Fouled away. 0-2. To the righty. Hillers, as a team, a 361 batting average through their first 3 games. Pretty impressive start. They are expected to have a good amount of hitting this season for sure. As this is hit in the air to center field, and it is gloved by the center fielder, Kate Irwin, for the 3rd and final out of the 2nd inning. It is 1-0 Milford as we head to the top of the 3rd. Top half of the 3rd inning, a 1-0 lead for the Milford Scarlet Hawks. As due up for Milford, it is the 2, 3, and 4 hitters. Emily Pierre-Gustavo at the plate now. We'll take that one high, 1-0. Jess Tomaso, Caitlin DeCapua, due up for Milford. As the righty steps back in and awaits the pitch, it's hit in the air, right side, and it is gloved. A good catch in right field by Katie Holly for the 1st out. I'll bring up Jess Tomaso. Tomaso hit a single in the 1st inning. She'll take that pitch inside. One and oh. And she's squaring the bunt right now. She'll pull off the bunt and hit this one to the shortstop. Throw to first is low, but a nice glove there by the first baseman, Madison Abbott. Off the Molly Bennett throw, 6-3 ground out, two away. Caitlin DiCapua will come up to the plate for Milford, the cleanup hitter. She flew out in the first inning. Wind up and the pitch in there for a strike. Tom Nappy on the call, Mike Tarosian on camera. Beautiful day here at Hopkinton High School. A little bit windy, temperatures in the lower 60s. That one is up high, 1-1. First official home game for the Hillers. They had to play their first home game at Medway due to a whole lot of rain that hit the area last week. A pitch inside, 2-1. A lot of teams had to move location for their first home game last week. But the field in great condition today. They really did a nice job getting it ready. 2-2. Hillers baseball team will have their first home game against Millis tomorrow. That one is up high, 2-1. There it is, and she draws the walk. Excuse me, it was a 3-1 pitch, and DiCapua's aboard. One on, two outs. Kelly Reichert, the first baseman to the plate. And this is hit in the air, a high fly ball to right field, and ranging under it, making the catch is Katie Hawley. And that'll do it for the inning. Two flyouts to Katie Hawley, keeping her busy in that third inning. We will head to the bottom of the third inning. It is Milford 1, Hopkinton nothing. It's Hillers softball on HCAM. Bottom of the third inning, 8-9-1 due up for the Hillers. Trail Milford 1-0. Julia D. Bendetto, Emily Whalen, and Lily Morningstar due up. D. Bendetto, the designated player today for the Hillers. Getting the at-bats for the catcher. She'll take strike one there. She's a freshman. She's had four plate appearances this season, all of them counting as at-bats. 1-for-4 from the plate, has driven in a run and scored a run. That one outside, 1-1. And we mentioned the wind has been a factor in this game, and the HCAM Weather Center reading a 5-mile-an-hour wind, blowing south-southwest. Atherton delivers, fouled away, 1-2.
Thank you to HCAM's meteorologist, Eric Cardi.
Best in the business right there. Of course, you can catch the weather trends on our website, hcam.tv. Get all the latest trends to what the weather's been like around the area. And that's courtesy of Eric Cardi. Atherton delivers on the ground, up the middle, gloved by the second baseman, throw to first, no problem. DiBendetto goes down 4-3. Emily Whalen, the second baseman, will come up now. Two for six so far at the plate for Emily Whalen, pretty good start. Has scored a couple runs and driven in one. Lefty steps in and awaits the pitch. And look bunt there, but she'll hold up. Ball one, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch, and this is a slow roller up the first baseline. Throw to first, gets away, and Whalen's going to be safe. And that is an error there by Atherton. And that was such a slow roller, an awkward play for Atherton to make. You could question if that's an error, but the throw is just little bit off there. It looks like it just slipped out of her hand, but the Hillers will take it. Lily Morningstar, the center fielder, will step into the batter's box. 0-for-1 so far this afternoon. Of course, it is school vacation week, so a lot of early starts. As Waylon thought about taking off from first, she'll go back to the bag. And she has a whole lot of speed and certainly a threat to steal. Is the sophomore Emily Whalen, who had a great season last year as well for the Hillers. Atherton set to deliver. That one just high. Well, Hopkinton knows if they want to score against this pitcher, Allie Atherton, they're going to have to manufacture a run. She is a very difficult pitcher to get a lot of hits off of. Whalen at first base. We'll head back to the bag as there's a strike to Morningstar. 2-1. Atherton awaits the sign. She delivers, and this is a liner that'll drop into right field. And everyone is going to be safe. A single for Morningstar. Whalen up to second. Hillers have something going here in the third inning with one out. And the infield will come in and have some words of encouragement for their pitcher, Allie Atherton, as Katie Holly will step in for the Hillers. It is a 1-0 lead for Milford, but Hopkinton threatening here in the bottom of the third inning, as now coach Steven DeVito will come out and talk to his pitcher as well. And Katie Holly will continue to take some warm-up swings, but it was tough to know what to expect for the Hillers coming into the season. You had Scott Soderberg take over for Kylie Murray, and of course, Coach Soderberg has a lot of experience with this Hillers softball team. He has been an assistant coach for a few years here for Hopkinton, but a whole lot of seniors graduated from last year's team, which had a great run, including starting pitcher Bree Mirabile. But Hopkinton seems to have picked up right where they left off to a 3-0 start so far. But they will have their hands full here with this very good Milford team. But this should be a great battle all the way down to the end. So strap in, folks. We're going to have a good one here. Katie Holly steps in. Atherton set to deal. There's a strike. 0-1. Two on, one out for the Hillers. First and second. Atherton deals, that is fouled away. 0-2. A good turnout by the Milford fans as well as the Hopkinton fans for this one. Nice crosstown matchup. These two teams meet once every season. This year it's in Hopkinton, next year it'll be in Milford, as long as the rivalry keeps going, which I'm sure it will. That one down low. 1-2. Holly struck out her only time up in this game in the first inning. Atherton set to deal. And that one is just outside, 2-2. Lefty steps back in. Winds and deals down low. Full count now. Well, this could be a strategy from Milford here. Maybe they're not afraid to walk Holly to load up the bases and go for the double play. But they could just be throwing her some pitches that are close to see if she swings at them. See what Holly throws here. And she'll leave that one over the plate. It'll drop into left field. That's a fair ball. One run is in to score. Second run being waved around as it rolls all the way towards the fence. Two runs are in for the Scarlet Hawks. And it is a two RBI triple for Katie Holly. 2-1 Hillers. Katie Holly legging it out all the way to third base. That one stuck in the left field corner. Jess Tommaso had some trouble with that one, and Hopkinton is on top. Lindsay Whittles will step in, the left fielder. Hillers with a chance to do more damage here, still only one out in the inning. Atherton set the deal, down low. One and oh count to Whittles, who struck out in the first inning. Katie Holly on third base. After driving in two runs, there's a strike, 1-1. Well, it is very rare you get an opportunity like this off of Allie Atherton, but the Hillers taking advantage of it. Two runs in, and it's a 2-1 lead for Hopkinton. Atherton set the deal. There's a strike, 1-2. Wind up and the pitch, fouled away. Count remains 1-2 on Whittles. Whittles, 286 to start off the season, 2-for-7. Has scored 4 runs and driven in 1. Down low, good eye, 2-2. This is where the Hillers have to keep this rally going. One out, big opportunity, runner on third. Line up and the pitch. Swinging strike, and Whittles will go down for out number 2. Molly Bennett, the cleanup hitter, will now come up, the shortstop. She struck out her last time up in the second inning. Atherton trying to avoid any further damage here as the Hillers have already plated 2. That one's hit in the air, foul ball over to the first base side past the bleachers. 0-1, just above us. Unfortunately, if the ball comes at me, I got Mike here to use as a shield.
Thanks. Is that why you keep standing behind me? I'm more worried about the missed catch at first.
Oh, absolutely. We've had a few close calls here. Atherton deals up high. 1-1.
I think the ball is big and yellow. I can see it better.
It is easier to see, that's for sure.
As it takes my face out.
And it's not coming at you 95 miles an hour usually. Runner on third, 2 outs for Hopkinton. 2 runs in off a Katie Holly 2 RBI triple. Fouled away, 1-2. Atherton taking her time here, thinking things over. When she's under pressure, she certainly does take a little bit more time between pitches. As this one's hit in the air to center field, and it's gloved. Good positioning by Kate Irwin, who was in the perfect spot to reel that one in. That is the third out, but the Hopkinton Hillers do plate a pair, and it is 2-1 as we head to the top of the fourth. Top half of the fourth inning. The Hillers have claimed the lead. It is 2-1. Milford coming up to the plate, however. The 6, 7, and 8 hitters do up. Emily Hartman, the catcher, will start things off, followed by Maddie Bonvino and Allie Atherton. Wind up and the pitch from Holly is just upstairs, 1-0. There Holly has pitched a nice game. The only run of the game was unearned in the second inning. As this is hit in the air, a high fly ball over towards shallow left field. Can anyone get there? No, it's going to drop. And that is going to be a single by Hartman. Was it an error? You could debate that, but we'll rule it a single for now as that dropped in front of the shortstop who ran out, Molly Bennett, as well as the left fielder, Lindsey Whittles. I don't know if that was a miscommunication or if the wind blew it around. The wind has certainly been a factor throughout the afternoon. But in any case, Milford has a runner on with no outs.
Yeah, with this wind going in every direction, Tom, the ball's dropping like a corkscrew.
Right. You know? Yeah, it did look like it was swirling around a bit up there as well. And we've seen a couple of those instances today. Bonvino steps in. That's fouled away, 0-1. Holly is going to deal, and that one is bunted foul, 0-2. On the season coming into this game, 15 strikeouts for Heather Holly. And she has certainly shown that she could be a dominant pitcher. And there's one right there, one away. That was a beauty of a breaking pitch. That is the second strikeout of this game for Holly. And now it's pitcher versus pitcher as Allie Atherton steps in. And this is a nice piece of hitting that'll drop into right field and get past the right fielder. The lead runner is Emily Hartman. She's gonna round third and try to score, and she will. And that is going to tie up the game at 2 apiece. Atherton is aboard at third base with the RBI. Hartman scores, and it's a 2-2 game as Coach Soderberg going to come out and talk to his infield. And that was a nice piece of hitting that dropped right in front of Katie Holly in right field and rolled just past her. She had to play it at an awkward angle. It was just a little bit too far out in front of it. And Atherton gets the job done to help her own cause here. Shannon Cormier, the right fielder, will step in. Runner on third, one out. And this is a slow roller up the first base side, and she will tag the runner, but the runner from third will come in and score. And no, they are going to bring everybody back. Okay, so they get her out, and they did call her out. Okay, the run did score, however, and it's 3-2. So Cormier gets the sacrifice. Thought she was tagged there.
Yeah, she was tagged. She was tagged down the line.
Yep, tagged down the line, and the play you wanted to make there was throw the ball right to the plate. As this is hit into left field, and that's going to drop fair. A base hit for Kate Irwin, who rounds first, and she's aboard with a double.
Oh. It's called out.
And now called out as she was tagged, stepping off the bag. And Hopkinton gets a break there as they will get the third out, but not before Milford reclaims the lead. It is 3-2 as we head to the bottom of the fourth. Bottom of the fourth inning, the Hillers coming back up to the plate. It is 5, 6, and 7 for the Hillers. Heather Holly, Emma Murphy, Madison Abbott. Milford has reclaimed the lead. They played 2 runs in the top of the fourth. And I want to go back to that last out, Kate Irwin, appear to have hit the ball and landed safely at second base, but they called her out, and we found out it was because she stepped out of the batter's box, so that is an automatic out if you make contact. So that is why Kate Irwin was out, and the inning ended as this one's popped up into shallow infield and gloved by the second baseman, Matty Bonvino, for the first out of the inning. That'll bring up Emma Murphy. That's a tough break for the Hillers. You get some momentum, you get the lead, and Milford gets it right back. And we'll recap that inning in just a moment after this pitch. As Murphy steps in, she singled her only other time up this game in the second. And takes one for a strike there. She swung at the low ball. Emily Hartman led off with a single. Matty Bonvino struck out. And then Allie Atherton, an RBI double to drive in Hartman. And then Shannon Cormier sacrificed down the first baseline to drive in Atherton. As that one's down low. And Madison Abbott was the first baseman. She tagged the hitter coming down the line, but hesitated throwing home, and Atherton just went for it. And Milford was able to manufacture the go-ahead run. So that one's fouled away. One and two on Murphy. Well, some good strategic softball going on here. Mm-hmm. It's really been a chess match between these two coaches, Mike.
Yeah, they really have. You're absolutely right on that. Good analogy right there.
You appeared as if you were going
to
add something.
I couldn't add to it because you hit it right on the head. So I'm leaving it all to you.
You got two very talented coaches here in this game, that's for sure. So that one is inside. Steven DeVita, of course, the head coach of the Milford Legion baseball team, post 59. Always does a great job with that program. And the head coach of this Milford softball program that is always an elite program. And this could be a potential playoff matchup right here between these two teams. They are in the same bracket as that one's fouled away. 2-2. Both of these teams certainly, I think, are going to have very good years. Emma Murphy having a great season at the plate so far, 4-for-6 overall. If she keeps this up, she will certainly be in that lineup on a daily basis. As this is on the ground, up the middle, Atherton bobbles it, picks it up, throws it a first in time. 1-3 there for the second out. Madison Abbott will come up. Madison Abbott, the first baseman. She is a senior. Line up and the pitch. And this is lined in the air to center field and handled for the third out of the inning as Irwin will glove it, and that will wrap up the fourth. To the top of the fifth we go. It is Milford 3, Hopkinton 2. It's Hiller softball on HCAN. Top half of the fifth inning, due up for Milford, the second, third, and fourth hitters. Emily Pierre-Gustavo, the shortstop. Jess Tomaso, the left fielder. Caitlin DiCapua, the third baseman. It's Heather Hawley out there for another inning of work. And this is a bunt that is a slow roller up the middle. Throw to first is low. Was she out? No. Safe is the call. So the umpire did not think Madison Abbott had a handle on it, and that is certainly close. That is one I'd like to take a look at on the replay, but that call certainly could have went either way. And Pierre Gustavo beats it out on the bunt. And Heather Hawley is having a tough time throwing the ball to first base this afternoon. Throws are just too low, and she's putting too much power on them. As Jess Tomaso takes a ball for her first pitch. Well, three runs have scored for Milford. Only one of them is earned. That pitch is down low. At least according to my scorebook. We'll get the official word after the game. Tomaso squaring to bunt. Milford trying to manufacture another run. She pulls back, however, and takes a ball. 3-0. cleanup hitter, Caitlin DeCapua, due up next. Jess Tommaso is 1-for-2 today, and she'll take ball four. Pierre Gustavo up to second. Tommaso at first, Caitlin DeCapua to the plate. Coach DeVito with the signal from the third base side to his base runners. And this is a slow roller up the third baseline, and it is foul. Well, you could have played that a couple ways there. You could have picked it up, tagged the third base bag, and got the runner, but it's certainly a risk. So she took the conservative route and let it roll out. Holly set to deliver to DeCapua, just outside. Stoppage signaled by the ump, time by the batter. Holly deals, up the middle, a rocket just past Holly's glove, and the runner will be held up at third, so it's bases juiced for Milford with no outs. A single by DeCapua pushes up Tommaso to second, Pierre Gustavo to third. That's some good base coaching by Coach DeVita. Would have been a very risky play at home, and now you got bases loaded, no outs. Kelly Reichert, the first baseman to the plate. Big opportunity here for Milford, trying to break this game open. Holly deals. There's a strike. Well, Holly's going to have to pitch her way out of this one. The 0-1. And this is going to be a hit into left field. One run is in, a second run being waved around, and it is a 2-RBI single by Kelly Reichert. Pierre Gustavo scores, as well as Tommaso. DeCapua up to second, and it's 5-2 Milford. And Emily Hartman up to the plate for the Scarlet Hawks. First, we'll have a discussion among the infielders for Hopkinton. As Milford has gained some momentum in this inning, a nice rally to kind of break this game open a little bit. And they have a chance to keep this going. Still no outs in the inning. You got two runners on. Emily Hartman to the plate. She's 1-for-2 so far this afternoon. Had a single in the fourth and scored the first run of the inning. That was off the Allie Atherton RBI double. And this is hit foul towards the stands area, 0-1. Holly awaits the sign. We do have some warm-up action in the Hillers bullpen area as that one is fouled away. 0-2. Getting loose for the Hillers appears to be Julia DiBendetto, who is the designated player as of right now, as this is up third base side, handled by the third baseman Emma Murphy. She'll tag the bag, throw to first, and she is able to get one runner, and they will give her the double play. A great piece of defense there by Emma Murphy over at third base. And she will get the 5-3 double play.
And that was a much needed play just for the sake of getting it in the girls' head that they're still in this.
Absolutely. Kelly Reichert pushed up to second. As there's ball one to Maddie Bonvino. This game far from over, especially with these Hillers bats. One upstairs. Yeah. Wind up and the pitch. Third base side foul. 2-1.
Be patient!
Set to deal. There's a strike, grabs the outside corner. 2-2.
Come on, Matty, come on, Matty!
Here's St. Milford!
Line up and the pitch. Upstairs, 3-2 now. Well, Heather Holly has had to work through some difficult rallies, but still has good command out there on the mound, as this is a little bloop shot, and that is going to drop in the back of the pitcher's circle, and that will be a base hit, a very tough play to make for the shortstop, Molly Bennett. And that was just an awkward hit. So Maddie Bonvino aboard with the single, Kelly Reichert up to third. Allie Atherton to the plate, there is two outs in the inning. Atherton 1-for-2 this afternoon, had an RBI double in the fourth. That one upstairs. For those of you just joining us, you're tuned in to Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. Tom Nappy on the call, Mike Terosian on camera. It's a 5-2 Milford lead in the top of the fifth as that one's fouled away, 1-1. A lot of action so far this afternoon between these two very good teams. Milford out of the Hockomock, Hopkinton out of the TVL. The Hillers in the lead right now in the TVL as they got a great victory on the road against Norton. There's a swinging strike there. 1-2. Runners on the corners for Milford. Two already in this inning. Holly deals. Upstairs inside, 2-2. Holly shakes off the first sign and is set to deliver. That one just upstairs, good eye by Atherton, full count. Atherton, great all-around softball player, very good pitcher, great hitter. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. Holly got her, will need it out there. We will head to the bottom of the fifth. It's Milford leading Hopkinton, 5-2. It's Hillers softball on HCAM. Bottom of the fifth inning, Milford leading Hopkinton, 5-2. Hillers softball on HCAM. Due up for the Hillers, 8-9-1. Julia DiBendetto, Emily Whalen, and Lily Morningstar. As DiBendetto will step in, she grounded out her only time up in this game in the third inning. Allie Atherton back out there, a premier pitcher for Milford. Has pitched a nice game so far against a very good Hillers batting order. As this is grounded up the first base side foul, 0-1. DiBendetto is warming up. Maybe come in for Heather Holly if the pitching struggles continue.
It'll be interesting to see if they let her get a few more pitches in or not. Or just go right for the change. I guess it might see how the bats do here.
Yeah, I think they'll bring her back out. But if she starts to struggle, I think the leash is very short. As this is lined up the right side into right field for the base hit. DiBendetto is aboard. A leadoff single, and now Emily Whalen will come up. She reached on an error in the third and scored a run. We'll see if the Hillers can get the bats going here, and Allie Atherton has thrown a good amount of pitches as well. She's had to work her way out of a couple jams. There's the pitch upstairs, 1-0. Emily Whalen, a tough hitter to throw to, draws a lot of walks. That one is low, 2-0. Yeah, Atherton looks over at first and is set to deal. She delivers. That one just outside, 3-0. Emily Whalen, a 333 on base percentage so far this season. Lays down the bunt, pulls it back, ball four. Two on, no outs for the Hillers. Big opportunity here. Here comes Lily Morningstar to the plate. Top of the order for the Hillers. Morningstar 500 batting average, 12 plate appearances coming into this game. 10 at-bats, 5 for 10, 4 RBIs, 6 runs scored. And she already has a hit in this game as well and a run scored in the third inning. 1 for 2 overall. And a chance to do some damage here. Lily Morningstar, terrific multi-sport athlete for the Hillers. Great basketball player as well. Atherton deals. There's a strike. A 583 on base percentage for Morningstar. Atherton deals. On the ground, third base side, gets past the dive of the third baseman, but picked up by the shortstop, and she will run over to the third base bag, and everyone is going to be safe. DiBenedetto just beat out the tag of the bag, and it is bases juice for Hopkinton with no outs. A great piece of hitting by Morningstar, and great speed as well by DiBenedetto beating that one out.
Yeah, if it wasn't here for speed, being so superior, she would have been out.
Absolutely. As soon as that ball was even touched by the bat, she left that second base bag. If she left a millisecond later, she would have been out. Katie Hawley takes a strike there, 0-1. Katie Hawley, the right fielder, she is 1-for-2. She had a 2-RBI triple in the third, scoring the only 2 Hillers runs of the game. Has a big opportunity here to drive in more. Swinging strike. Atherton with the heat there, not messing around. Atherton taking her time here in a jam. Holly awaits the pitch. And she is going to hit this one in the air to left field, and it is caught. The runner will tag from third and score. So one will come around for the Hillers. It's 5-3. So DiBenedetto scores on the sacrifice by Holly.
Peel at third base was safe.
One away. Lindsay Whittles will come up to the plate. One out, still two on for the Hillers. You got Whalen at second, Morningstar at first. Big opportunity here for Lindsay Whittles, who is 2-for-7 so far this season at the plate, coming into this game now 2-for-9 with 2 strikeouts today. There's strike one. Molly Bennett, the cleanup hitter, due up next. Atherton set to deal. Swinging strike there, 0-2. Will's just struggling with Atherton today. Atherton deals that one low. was a good job by Katie Holly, at least getting one of those runs around. Exactly what the Hillers needed. Wills trying to get a couple more around. Atherton delivers. Swinging strike there. The ball got away from the catcher, but it is going to be called out. Two away. Molly Bennett now with a big opportunity here. The cleanup hitter, 0 for 2 today so far. Two outs, two on. One in for the Hillers in the bottom of the fifth. 5-3 Milford lead. Atherton deals. Swinging strike, blew it by her. Atherton with a lot of fastballs with the last couple hitters. She left a couple of the breaking pitches over the plate, which allowed the Hillers to start a rally. And now going more towards the fastball. That one upstairs, 1-1. There's a swinging strike, 1-2. Atherton awaits the sign. Set to deliver. And this is a fly ball into right field, and stepping back to make the catch is the second baseman, Maddie Bonvino. Had to play that one in a shallow right field, did a nice job, and that's the third out. The Hopkinton Hillers do get a run across, and as we head to the top of the sixth, it's Milford 5, Hillers 3. It's Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. Top half of the sixth inning, a 5-3 lead for Milford over the Hillers. Two up, it's 9-1-2 as Shannon Cormier will take ball one, the right fielder. Well, both Milford and Hopkinton compete in the same playoff bracket, the South Division I bracket. Both of them had nice runs last year. 2-0 now to Cormier. Milford went to the quarterfinals and lost to Silver Lake 5-0. Milford went all the way to the semifinals and lost to King Philip 4-0. But two very good runs, and look at that catch by the catcher, Cedia. What a great diving play that was. That was a beauty. Little bloop shot. Pop up just in front of the plate, and Cedia making the dive.
Well, let's see what that looks like on the replay.
Put that one in slow motion. Jillian Cedia, the catcher for the Hillers. Making it happen there. As Irwin is going to lace this one in a right center. That'll drop in for a base hit. She's going to round first, throw to second, and will get past the reach of the second baseman. And Irwin is aboard with the two base hit.
Hey, nice job, Lily. Way to get in it quick. That girl, good job.
And she will go over and give a high five to Coach DeVita. Good piece of hitting and a great job legging that one out to second base. As the pitch to Pierre Gustavo's up high. She got lucky. That throw was just a little past the reach of the shortstop, Molly Bennett. There's a swinging strike on a breaking pitch there.
Nice little change up there. She was about a second ahead of that one.
Yeah, some good movement on that one. 1-1. And this is hit high in the air to center field towards the fence, and that's gone. Home run, Scarlet Hawks. A two-run bomb by Emily Pierre-Gustavo. And that is not what the Hillers wanted with that one. And it is 7-3.
I think we're gonna need the trainer to go out and.
And yeah, we might have an injured player out there, and the center fielder, I believe it is, was trying to play it against the fence.
Yeah, she hit that kind of hard.
She's being helped off. It's Lily Morningstar, who was shooken up. She's being helped off by a couple of her teammates. Hopefully she's okay. I'm guessing it's an ankle injury, but she'll be helped off. It's 7-3 Milford, and we're going to take a quick break while she's helped off the field. You are watching Hiller softball on HCAM. Continuing on with the sixth inning after a two-run homer for Pierre Gustavo, Tomas will take a strike. It's one out, two runs in for Milford in the top of the sixth. A two-run homer by Emily Pierre Gustavo, and Lily Morningstar got shooken up trying to play it as this one's hit in the air to center field, and it is gloved by the new center fielder, Katie Holly, who moved over from right. Lily Rankintore takes over in right field for the Hillers. There's two away. That'll bring up Caitlin DeCapua, who will foul this one away, 0-1. Heather Holly still out there for the Hillers on the mound. And that was just a beauty of a hit by Emily Pierre Gustavo right past the center field fence. Great power underneath. As a nice breaking pitch there has DeCapua fooled, 0-2. Well, this Milford batting order is certainly one of the best in the area, and they are showing it here this afternoon. Both of these teams expected to do big damage this season as this one's popped up in a left field under it, and the catch is made by Whittles, and that will wrap up the top half of the sixth inning. It is 7-3 Milford as we head to the bottom of the inning. Bottom of the sixth inning, the Hillers coming up to the plate with some work to do, trailing 7-3 against the Milford Scarlet Hawks. It's Heather Holly, the pitcher, leading things off against Allie Atherton. Atherton has pitched a very good game for the Scarlet Hawks so far. But at times, the Hillers have been able to hit off her. Up in the pitch, and this is a liner up the middle. That's going to get through. A leadoff single for Heather Holly. Well, this game's not over yet. If the Hillers can get a rally going, they can easily get right back into this. Emma Murphy will come up to the plate, and we're going to have a pinch runner for Heather Holly.
Hey, nice hit, Heather.
So they're going to get some speed on the base paths here. Heather Holly comes out, and we have the pinch runner in there for Hopkinton. As Allie Atherton will take some time here. It's Haley Keefe in there as the pinch runner for the Hillers. Of course, in softball, you can bring in the pinch runner, but bring in the hitter right after. Mm-hmm. Actually, you can do that in the high school baseball as well. Of course, once you get into the Legion level, that rule does not apply, as that one's fouled away by Murphy. The wind really picking up here in these later innings. We'll see if it helps the Hillers. Right now the wind appears to be blowing to the right side. Big gusts at times. One on, no outs. Hillers trying to get something going, trailing by four. There's strike two to Murphy. Atherton's set to deal. And this is up the middle, past the reach of the shortstop, and it's going to be a hit. Two on for the Hillers. Murphy will reach. Whether that was an error or not is negotiable. It was right at the shortstop, but it took an awkward angle towards Pierre Gustavo. But there is two on, no outs for the Hillers, so they got something going here. Madison Abbott will come up for Hopkinton, the first baseman. She is 1-for-2 today. Had a single and scored a run in the fifth. Hillers threatened last inning, and now they're threatening again. They are not going away, that's for sure. There's a strike. And you wonder what the leash is with Allie Atherton. She's had to work her way through a couple of jams and thrown quite a few pitches out there, but there has been no warm-up action yet for Milford. Of course, Coach DeVita has a lot of faith in his starting pitcher. As this is hit in the air, a pop fly over to right field, and it is handled for the out. No runner advancement.
Way to talk to each other.
Good communication out there in right field as that one was right on the border between Irwin and Cormier. Cormier calls off Irwin and makes the play. And now Julia DiBendetto, the designated player, will step in. She's 1-for-2. She had a single in the fifth and scored a run. She grounded out her first time up this game in the third. Can she do some damage here? Emily Whalenwood is on deck next. She's reached twice. It's down the first baseline, and it is right to the first baseman who scoops it up for the out. Kelly Reichert with a nice catch there. And that will retire the side in the sixth inning. To the seventh we go. You are watching Hiller softball on HCAM. Top half of the seventh inning. Milford with a 7-3 lead trying to add on. Kelly Riker, the fifth hitter in the lineup, steps in, and it's ball one to start things off. 5, 6, and 7 due up for Milford. Kelly Riker at the first baseman, Emily Hartman the catcher, Maddie Bonvino the second baseman. And there's strike two. Hillers threatened last inning, but a beauty of an unassisted double play by the first baseman, Kelly Riker, ended things in that inning. And she was able to make a great catch on a low flying ball down the first baseline. She was able to scoop it up just before it hit the ground and tag the bag for the double play. That one is inside. That'll make it a full count on Reichert. That one outside, she draws the walk. Good eye there. Emily Hartman, the catcher, will come up to the plate. And first, head coach Scott Soderberg is going to come talk to Heather Hawley. He'll take the ball. We'll have a relief pitcher for the Hillers. And it is going to be the designated player. Well, at least the designated player she was to start the game. Julia DiBendetto coming out to pitch for the Hopkinton Hillers. So as they make the pitching change, we'll take a timeout. It's Hillers softball on HCAM. Top of the seventh, new pitcher for the Hopkinton Hillers. It is Julia DiBendetto out there, and the first pitch of her outing is going to be hit into left center. That is a base hit for Emily Hartman. The lead runner stopped at third, and that is a double. No out double for Hartman. And Lucy Creedon, who came in as the pinch runner for Kelly Reichert, is now on third base. Maddie Bonvino, the second baseman, will come up to the plate for the Scarlet Hawks. So an opportunity for Milford here to add on to their four-run lead. And there's a strike from the new pitcher, Julia DiBendetto. DiBendetto, a freshman. Throw that one outside. Excuse me, that is a strike, 0-2. DiBendetto set the deal. That one upstairs. 1-2.
Stay hot, kids. Stay hot.
Wind up and the pitch. That one just high. That'll even up the count at 2-2. Andy Bonvino is One for three today. She reached on an error in the second and scored a run and then singled in the fifth, as well as struck an out. This one's popped up foul territory and it'll be handled by the catcher. Nice catch there by Jillian Cedia. That is the first out of the inning. Allie Atherton, the pitcher, steps in.
We say 2-1.
That first pitch is just high. 1-0. Runners on second and third for Milford, 1-0. Allie Atherton had an RBI double in the fourth and scored a run off a sacrifice RBI by Shannon Cormier, the right fielder. That was the second and third runs of the inning for Milford. That one's fouled away. 1-1. That one upstairs got away, and Cedia will be quick to get to it. Runner will hold up at third. 2-1. She deals, and there's a swinging strike. 2-2. Also has warm-up action now in case your pitcher Allie Atherton, who's batting right now, runs into any trouble. And depending on the pitch count, you could see a new pitcher from Milford next inning. Atherton takes a ball there, that'll fill up the count. 3-2. Warming up, it is the first baseman for Milford to pitch, as there's a swinging strike. And that will be out number two, Kelly Reichert. And now Shannon Cormier steps in. That one up high to the lefty, 1-0.
Got a higher one, she's got a higher one.
She deals upstairs, 2-0. Milford started off the inning with a walk, and then that would be the last we saw of Heather Hawley. And Dee Bendetto came in, and it was a double by Hartman, but since then, a pair of outs. But now it's a 3-0 count on Shannon Cormier, the right fielder. That one upstairs, she draws the walk. Well, was that an intentional walk by DiVendetto? It could have been to get a play all over the diamond. But more than likely not, because right now you got Kate Irwin, who was a very good hitter, coming up to the plate. She will take strike one, 0-1. Hillers 3-0 on the season, Milford 4-1. Milford trying to hand Hopkinton their first loss of the season. That one upstairs, 1-1. Hillers will be down to their final three outs. Next inning, trailing by four. As DiVendetto out there trying to have some damage control here. Up the middle, and that'll get through. One run in, and a second run will be stopped at third. Coach DeVito getting in front of the lead runner, Hartman, who stopper coming down the line, and a good thing for Milford because that was a great throw in from Katie Holly over in center field, but a good piece of hitting by Irwin, an RBI single. Add some insurance for Milford. 8-3 now. And As the first pitch to Emily Pierre-Gustavo is a ball.
Come on, Emily.
So Emily Hartman over at third. That one is upstairs. Runners on the corners, two outs for Milford. Emily Pierre-Gustavo having a pretty good day. She's reached base three times. One of those times off an error. She's walked and hit that two-run homer in the sixth. That one is down low. Two-run homer, which drove in Kate Irwin, and of course herself, to make it seven runs for Milford at that point and give them the 7-3 lead. That one upstairs. Three and one count. That's fouled away. Bases juiced for Milford, two outs. Irwin on first, Cormier on second, Hartman on third. Lineup and the pitch. Upstairs, and that's going to walk in a run. Now 9-3 Milford. Emily Hartman comes around to score. Cormier up to third. Irwin up to second. Pierre-Gustavo to first. And Coach Soderberg going to talk to his pitcher, DiBenedetto, who started off good. Looked like she was going to get through this inning with minimal or no damage, but now struggling a bit. Jess Tomaso coming to the plate for the Scarlet Hawks, now up 9-3. Now one upstairs, 1-0. There's a swinging strike, 1-1. DiBenedetto set the deal. On the ground, third base side, gloved by the third baseman. Murphy will tag the bag for the final out. So a force out at third, but not before Milford plates another pair. It is 9-3, Milford leading Hopkinton, heading to the bottom of the seventh on HCAM. Bottom half of the seventh, the Hillers down to their final three outs, trailing Milford 9-3. A lot of work to do. Allie Atherton still out there for the Scarlet Hawks to try to pitch the complete game. Emily Whalen, the ninth hitter in the batting order, will lead things off. She's reached on an error and walk so far. Hillers going to have their work cut out for them in this final inning. Here's a bunt, and it's strike one. Set the deal. And this is up the third base side, off the glove of the third baseman. That's a fair ball. And the infield was playing in, and that helped out Whalen there as DiCapua tried to make a dive for it, but a little bit too fast up the line, and Whalen is aboard with the leadoff single. And once again, that one debatable, error single. But in either case, the Hillers will take it as stepping in for Hopkinton is Lily Rancatori. Came in for Lily Morningstar, who was injured on that two-run homer. Trying to play it against the fence. And it's strike one to Rancatori. Atherton set the deal. That one just high. One and one. One on, no outs for the Hillers. Heather Holly, or Katie Holly, due up next. There's a swinging strike there as the sun starts to peek through. It's been mostly cloudy skies throughout this game. 1-2 on Rankator. Atherton set to deal. And this is hit into left field. That'll drop in for a base hit. And then it is bobbled by Tommaso over in left field. And Whalen will push up to third. Great piece of hitting by Rankator as she is aboard. Two men on for the Hillers with no outs. So a single, and then she reaches second on the error. It was the second error of the game for Milford. As Lindsay Whittle steps in. There's a strike. Wind up and the pitch, down low. Katie Holly board at second and Whalen at third. One out for the Hillers. There's a strike. And the pitch, down low. Upstairs. Three and two on Whittles. And that is going to be a walk. That'll load up the bases with one out. Now Molly Bennett will come up, the shortstop. As Coach DeVito will go out to the mound and talk to Allie Atherton. He's gonna take the ball, we'll have a relief pitcher. It's gonna be Reichert coming in for Atherton. So we'll have a pitching change and we'll take a timeout. It's Hiller softball on HCAM. Kelly Reichert in the game for Milford to pitch. She moves over from first base. Jess Tommaso moves over from left field and she'll take over at first base as there's a strike to Molly Bennett. Base is loaded for Hopkinton, one out. Reichert set to deal. There's a strike, 1-2. Set to deliver, just outside. One and two. We'll recap the inning in just a moment for you. Windup and the pitch. That's fouled away first base side. 2-2. Start off the inning, Emily Whalen hit a single. Lily Rancator then struck out. Katie Holly reached second base. She had the single and then reached second on a misplay in left field. Whittles then walked. So that's how you have the bases loaded with one out. Windup and the pitch. That's fouled away. Reichert set to deal. Upstairs. Oh, it is. Now, quite the situation here. As Hopkinton has the bases loaded. And Bennett, an opportunity to draw the walk. On the ground, up the middle, and it'll be gloved by the second baseman who flicks it to short for one. And they get the runner at second, but Whalen comes around to score. That is the second out of the inning. So Molly Bennett reaches first, and she will get the RBI. The force out at second. On the 4-6 force out. Run does score. Katie Holly up to third. Now, up to the plate, it is Heather Holly who will take a strike. Heather Holly now the designated player. She started the game as the pitcher. Then the designated player, Julia DiVendetto, came in, which just means they swap positions but stay in the batting order the same. There's strike two. One strike away for Milford. To claim their fifth victory of the season and hand Hopkinton their first loss of the season. That one upstairs, 1-2. Wind up and the pitch. Down low. 2-2. Upstairs. Full count now on Heather Holly. Nine to four game, two outs though for the Hillers. Kelly Reichert in the game for Milford facing her second hitter. Up the middle, glove by the second baseman, throw to first, no problem, and that will do it. The Milford Scarlet Hawks will get the victory over the Hopkinton Hillers. The final score, Milford 9, Hopkinton 4, a tough loss for the Hillers as they will fall to 3-1 on the season. The Milford Scarlet Hawks improving to 5-1 overall. And I think in this game they really showed how good of a team they are. But of course both of these teams expected to be very good all season long and could perhaps see each other again once in the playoffs. Both of them expected to make it, that's for sure. We'll take a quick timeout and give you the final numbers. It's Hiller softball on HCAM. The Milford Scarlet Hawks defeat the Hopkinton Hillers by a final score of 9-4. A tough loss for Hopkinton against a very good Milford team. Hopkinton falls to 3-1 on the season. The Scarlet Hawks are now 5-1. This game certainly had some back and forth moments. The first run was scored in the second inning after Maddie Bonvino reached on an error by the third baseman. Shannon Cormier drove her in to make it 1-0. That would remain the score until the very next half inning. As on the bottom of the third, the Hillers were able to plate a pair of runs. Emily Whalen reached on an error with one out. And then Lily Morningstar would single, and then Katie Holly had a two RBI triple to drive in Morningstar and Whalen. That would make it 2-1 Hillers, but Milford would respond. Top half of the fourth inning, a single by Emily Hartman with no outs. Maddie Bonvino then struck out, but Allie Atherton came up and knocked in Hartman with an RBI double. And then Shannon Cormier would reach on a sacrifice, which drove in Atherton, and that would put Milford up 3-2 heading in to the bottom of the fourth. The Hillers would score no runs. Milford added two more in the top half of the fifth off a two RBI single from Kelly Reichert, which drove in Emily Pierre Gustavo and Jess Tommaso. At that point, the game was 5-2. The Hillers would respond with a run on the bottom of the fifth. Julia DiBenedetto would score off a sacrifice flyout by Katie Holly. And then after that, however, Milford would score two more runs. A two-run blast past the center field fence by Emily Pierre Gustavo drives in Kate Irwin, and that would make it a 7-3 lead for the Scarlet Hawks. And Hopkinton, they would add a run on the bottom of the seventh, but it would be too little, too late. Milford did add two more runs in the top half of the seventh, as well as Kate Irwin drove in Kelly Reichert, her pinch runner Lucy Creedon at the time, and then Emily Pierre Gustavo walked to drive in Emily Hartman as the bases were loaded, and you get your final score 9-4, Milford defeating Hopkinton. The Scarlet Hawks scored 9 runs on 12 hits, committed 2 errors, while the Hopkinton Hillers scored 4 runs on 10 hits, committing 2 errors. Hillers left 7 men on base today, as Sally Atherton did a nice job getting out of some jams for the Scarlet Hawks. Well, a tough loss here for Hopkinton, but still a long way to go on this season, and it is certainly some great competition that you can learn some very good lessons from here early in the year. But I expect to see both of these teams in the South Division I playoff bracket, and who knows, hopefully they'll both see each other in the postseason as well. For Mike Terosian on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. This has been Hopkinton Hillers softball on HCAM. The final score for the final time, Milford defeats Hopkinton 9-4. We thank you for watching this presentation of HCAM Sports. Enjoy the rest of your day, everybody.